talk Wednesdays at Daffodils by Artemis. I am Dr. Mahima Bakshi, a maternal child wellness consultant, and my today's guest with me is Dr. Nutan Agarwal, who is the HOD of Obs and Gyne at Artemis and Daffodils. She is also the ex-professor of Obs and Gyne department from AIIMS New Delhi. I welcome ma'am to our show.
Hello.
Hi ma'am. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. We will be discussing today about preconception care to have a healthy and a normal baby. So ma'am, please tell us about how a woman can take care of herself before planning to conceive.
You see, every couple who wants to conceive, it is the best that they should take a preconception care by a doctor before they go further planning for the pregnancy. Because it is very important to find certain diseases or to give some certain supplementation which can help them to have a healthy and normal baby. So there are various procedures, various tests, investigations and history which we take before planning for the pregnancy. Then it is better if they take the care before the pregnancy.
Right.
And usually we prefer them, actually if you see there are two types of the pregnancy. One may be the first pregnancy or the previous normal pregnancies, or second may be which is a high risk pregnancy where they may have a previous abnormal outcome in the form of recurrent abortions or death or abnormal babies. So those who are coming with the first pregnancy or previous normal, they should report at least 3 months before the conception, because this is the time we usually give some supplementation and test before that. What all that I will discuss. Second thing is the high risk pregnancies like the previous abortions or previous dead baby, the abnormal babies. Before that, we go for certain investigations and then we diagnose what was the cause, because certain diseases can be treated beforehand or the investigation can be taken before they get the pregnant, because again otherwise in the pregnancy there will be the problem.
Right, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And ma'am, once a woman has conceived and her urine pregnancy test has come positive, when is the right time for her to report to a gynecologist that she has conceived?
Yeah. So that is actually very, very important, because the long time concept was that, oh, after 3 months you will report to the doctor, initially nothing has to be done. But it is not now same. The first trimester is the most important trimester, because there are so many things we investigate at that time. We screen the patients for chromosomal anomalies. Mm-hmm. We test for so many things which we correct at that time, because that is the time when the fetus is developing. All the organs are forming, and whatever that is the period where if something is wrong, then it may affect to the fetus maximum. So I think as soon as they diagnose the pregnancy, they have to report immediately.
Right.
So,
and ma'am, are there any conditions that actually can be prevented in the pre-pregnancy phase?
Yeah. You see, there, if you see a fetus well-being, there are three types. One is they should be structurally normal. There should be no abnormality to the organs or any part of the body. Second thing, they should have a normal chromosomes pattern. And third thing, we have to prevent certain diseases. So as far as the structural formation is concerned, that depends, that are diagnosed at the time of ultrasound at 12 weeks or around 18 to 20 weeks. But if they come before pregnancy, there are certain diseases like there is a diabetes, there is a thyroid, which can lead to the problem to the baby. So, or the patient may be on certain drugs like epilepsy drug, hypertension drugs, which we need to change before pregnancy so that it will not affect to their pregnancy abnormally. So these things are very important: renal disease, hypertension, diabetes, thyroid. These all things have to be investigated beforehand, and then we have to treat them. It is very, very important, especially if you see for the diabetes. If the patient is having diabetes and she conceives and it's not diagnosed in the first 3 weeks, there may be a normal baby. Not only that, now it is the concept that there is a fetal origin of adult disease. Now this is a theory that most of the origin of the adult disease starts in the fetal life. So if you don't correct the initial phase, the fetal metabolism may be affected. And if the uterine milieu is changed at that moment, the fetal development will affect, and in the late adult life they may precipitate with the disease. Like in the diabetes, if it is not diagnosed and not treated, the blood sugar will go to the fetus, the pancreas will work more, and the baby's pancreas will be exhausted before the time, and maybe the baby will have a diabetes later in the life. So So this is very, very important that all the disease, thyroid and all, have to be diagnosed beforehand. Second thing, I would say the thalassemia, because we want to prevent even first thalassemic baby. So we have to screen all the women. Previously we used to say only anemic, but sometimes we see in our practice that even the hemoglobin is normal, still they are having thalassemia traits. So we have to prevent the first thalassemic baby. So we have to investigate them before the pregnancy, or at least in the immediately after diagnosis pregnancy, so that we can investigate the genes and find out what is the reason and we can treat them. Third thing I will tell for the aneuploidy screening, which is very important, which usually we start from the early pregnancy. So when they come, we go for the dual marker screening, for the ultrasound screening. And here I want to tell to the patients that it is very important that if the test is coming abnormal, it does not mean that the baby is abnormal. It means that only the baby is having increased risk of having a abnormal baby, because we don't want to test all the babies for the chromosome test. So we do the screening, and if something comes in that, then we go for the testing by amniocentesis or some other test. But now there are a very sensitive test available where the fetal blood can be tested in the maternal blood, and we can directly test certain chromosomes specifically for Downs or other things, that baby may be affected. So that test can be offered to the patient.
Absolutely. So I think keeping these points in mind can really help in preventing a lot of conditions.
Lot of conditions. Actually, it is very, very important, and we should highlight this, that every woman have to go up to the, every woman should go to a doctor before planning for any baby and so, early pregnancy.
And early pregnancy as well. So I think these are some amazing tips by Dr. Agarwal ma'am, who shared on how to have a healthy and a normal baby by planning good preconception care. So ma'am, thank you so much for joining us for this lovely show.
Thank you.
And it was lovely talking to you.
Okay, nice to talk to you too.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.